another fear.
All right. Retired major, you don't go out for some time. Now you don't come. Brigadier, sorry. You don't come back to the country. Just take me through. The last time you come because of the Ebola. Where you can say the support for the flood victim and press releases and let's do it in the same. This time I'm only cancelled. Final kind of cancel.
No, I'm not kind of finally, but this is home, so final not the for me come one. When I know say the country don't go through very difficult times from last year. Ebola, the flood and other issues. So I've been come about 2 times and I go around, you know, although my movement been limited as a result of the emergency and I respect the emergency we've put in place to make me able to combat Ebola. But now I really want to go around after, because Ebola is almost over, and say thank you. One to the government, because whatever be the situation, I think they don't do a good fight, and the local governments then, all around the country, and also talk to individuals, group, civil society, the journalists, them, the teachers, the nurses in particular, health professionals, we've been in at the front line, to say thank you to them, and for encourage them, to make, we push further, to now finally bring an end to this scourge.
Right, this time when we don't come, in terms of activities, which is playing for the CEO day to most people?
Just with you, I tell you so. I want to go around the country, at various communities, and say thank you to the authorities, the Madden communities, and they, you know, you, at different levels, you all. When I say, which map my, when I make my own contribution, I got to find time for Ghana on places, them, various houses, them. And say thank you, because I feel say we need national cohesion, we'll get national problems. We all belong to different parties, we come from different regions. But when we get national issues like Ebola, the flood, we know the peak. I think say we for develop the habit now, for the put aside the differences, political, whatever the differences are, and work together. Even on most times we blame government alone for lack of development. I think say development not will take place and become sustainable without national cohesion. We for this together as a nation. It no matter who say homo, not this country, no matter which my tribe, it no matter which political color you carry, we get to work together from this country.
In terms of objectivity, these days we talk more of the Westerners. You hardly criticize, you support government development. Doesn't mean you want to bring in another system of governance, Nasalo?
Well, I want to be constructive when I criticize. And where did Ebola start? If you remember the first letter where I write to the president, and everybody, the international community, I appeal to everybody, say, make we put aside with differences. You know, we get fire inside your house, then we are the first, we are left the fire. Whatever difficulties we get among us, we have to put that off and infect the common enemy. The last time, me and the flag there for SFDP, and at the vibe for that position again. And when the time comes for make, we put out policies where the counter waiting the government in place, they don't do. We can put out them policy then. But for now, I think say we get threats and we come onto war. We not threats to all physical and emotional beings then. We're not affect to everybody. We need to make sure so you take care of them carefully before we talk about anything. So I want to make sure so this isn't very constructive. And I'm not getting to that mood yet. When I get into the mood, I know how I can do it.
Okay, Mr. B, also, if you don't deny the continent and you don't receive or don't get, waiting they carry on the continent, looking at the political landscape and also how the governance they run at it. Because let me look at the political landscape, how it began to carry on. How you belong to see that? What are some of the messages that when you belong to get, when you belong to over, when you belong to out of the country, now that you don't listen to it?
Of course, they get mixed messages, and now that make it fine for come home if you're out. Get you own, make your own assessment of the situation, and then you go know how you will react.
What are some of them mixed messages then?
Well, of course, we get part of the society, we not like waiting to happen, and we get another group, we like waiting to happen. So, in my opinion, if I get for make any genuine assessment, one, we will be informed, besides waiting me down here, many stuff can see waiting to happen. Then I go know what here to talk about some of the critical issues bordering on governance and other things that really happen in the country.
What are some of the critical issues then where you think say they really fall in the country?
But of course, as a result, even before the Ebola, we economy, of course, don't they go through difficulties. And with Ebola, they just don't put a serious strain on the economy. And that is one. Our governance issues, they're also there. We get different views about how we want to see how things are going at this country. And different people, they don't raise their own concerns then from their own perspectives then. And myself, we don't express quite a lot of that until we get Ebola. And when Ebola is out, I will know what they are doing in terms of projecting and putting out me own suggestions then as far as some of them problems can be
concerned. Certain people within your party and outside the party, they even refer to you and your supporters as power. What do you take for that particular name there? What do you think of that?
Well, that's not a name where anybody, they can give you any name. And when you say power, that means you insist on what you believe in, saying that that could be. But in a democracy, the majority, the view, not always, they prevail. If the majority inside the SNPP is then a Paupa, then that is a democracy.
So like you endorse the name Paupa?
Not to make it for endorse the name Paupa. Paupa, if you not believe in them, you will get a different connotation. But we say Paupa, this country for good before. Paupa, this country for better. Paupa, we for unite in the SNPP. And Paupa, saloon for get sustainable development.
You understand, say, somebody may divide for the same position we go for kind of unit at the country as well. And we understand the toss making there between the two factions. So which you will promise the people we're going to like say no get any like a misunderstanding and we can't get you ever push a particular fight.
We really no need for engage because we they compete for a position and there are rules and regulations within the party
promoting
peace where we meet. We get for regulate how we go about that. We no need to get any clash because me don't on the ground for the past 10 years and I don't day inside the party. If anybody come, they for ask me how things are run and maybe join we the right way. Me not get any problems with anybody. You go see say I'm not you not go cite any word from me against any potential flag bearer. And I'm not to say anything bad about any potential flag bearer. The SRPP is a democratic party. Anybody who want to join, they get right to join. And procedures then they were established. We miss the self follow. And we meet on council. I get for make sure say waiting the party say, not to waiting miss it. So in terms of peace, definitely, we want more party win. We get for support. The peace initiative and the one that we're doing, the one that we will not say will bring about genuine peace for the party. Anybody we stand for peace and we come for peace for purpose within the party, we'll work together.
The third break there, in terms of confidence of winning the flag bearer for the second time, if you say you could beat your other contender in the game?
Well, definitely, that now one thing we have one for sure now. To say on a level playing field, on any day, everybody without contest have been defeated.
Among your colleagues, then, the aspirant, then, the people who want for tonight for the flagship of the SFP, what is special from you, from the others?
Well, I don't build support. I not climb no more and grab. I been get a strategy, and the strategy don't work. I build support from the ordinary man within the party. So from the bottom to the top, I don't able convince everybody say, me not true SFPP, I don't make sacrifices for SFPP, and me not to just an opportunity at the can sit inside SFPP. Me na SFPP, I don't join, I don't work. Most I are not being win, I follow the party and campaign. And I don't succeed for convince the members of the party, both seniors and the rank and file, for say me na a true SFPP, I ready for stand for them. And now that make at the top with confidence say, on a level playing field, any day I will take on all of them and I go beat them.
You look so optimistic. If you happen to see you go in for the position where everybody they intend for go for, and you happen to see you lose, you still go there in the SFPP?
I'll be even more optimistic in 2005 where I lost and I still inside the SFPP.
Richard Brigade.
I've said that several times.
Richard Brigade, my colleague, they talk about good governance. And we get the constitutional issues we just passed. If it ain't a court, it could be a VP issue. Now, court on the judgment. We know say we can talk about that now. What now is the position for the outcome of the judgment and the president's action?
Well, what I remember say, where the election been done, I've been petitioned within NEC be declared the position where they be declared. But in a country, we say we get the rule of law, we all get for respect. And even when you disagree with what the Supreme Court say, then make them call it Supreme. Beyond that, you never get any other further interpretation, except like who did inside the ECOWAS region, you decide for take them out of Saloon and go to ECOWAS. Even if I disagree with the decision, we get for respect, and at that I will call on everybody, because now that have been due. Because in any country around the world, we order embrace democracy, and one of the strongest pillars of democracy is the rule of law. So we'll get with diverse opinions. But if we get for make sure, say, we get a peaceful society, where the Supreme Court come out and make a statement, even if we not believe in them, even if we not and I'll go with we own conviction. I think say we for respect them, and that I will do so far.
Finally, crowding a free tongue way, we understand say they wait for welcome you. Waiting are your expectation and waiting are your message to them. You did live on radio now.
Well, the crowd definitely don't follow me for a very long time. Like I say, I don't convince the people of Sierra Leone too. That's for say me, like a true citizen of this country, a patriot, we fight for this country, we don't make me your contribution. And the support we are getting, it not surprise me at all. The tell we say, Saloon don't come of age, they now know the difference between the one day we just come for take position, and the one day we're ready for make the sacrifice. I've done make sacrifice before, and I'm ready for make another one, this time a big one, and I will give Saloon a quantum leap in development we will one day see. If the people of this country trust me enough and give me the leadership.
So let them continue for waiting a free time you come.
Adina Road.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Well, that's now.